Yep, finally direct from Microsoft Xbox themselves, the Xbox Series S is finally official. Hi, Ben from Lover of Tech. If you enjoy content like this, you know exactly what to do. Hit that subscribe button, hit that notification bell so you're part of Team TLS, the Tech Lover Squad, so you don't miss any new content that's posted onto the channel. Let's get on with it. And man, oh man, the cat and mouse game between Xbox and PlayStation with their upcoming next-gen consoles for the holiday season for 2020 is getting more and more interesting. Now, for all the critiques that we've given Microsoft in regards to their game showcasing for their new consoles, the official announcement of the Series S, aka codenamed the Lockhart, looks to be a strong and good look for Microsoft, no doubt. Firstly, the price. In the UK, it's gonna be £249 or US $299 for a next-gen capable console. That is insanely good value for money. And some might even say it's beyond well priced, even cheap. Like, this is a good look. Now, the design of it looks sleek and compact, in my opinion, and Xbox are claiming the Series S to be nearly 60% smaller than the Series X, claiming it to be the smallest Xbox made so far. Not sure if they're going to be any other colorways, but Microsoft are showcasing an all-white design with a circular black vent, with the overall console standing in vertical orientation. But personally, I feel it would suit more horizontal compared to the Series X, which looks more akin to a vertical orientation position. There is still a custom NVMe storage for the Series S with things like seamless game switching that is being stated from Microsoft. Now, it's an all digital experience with no disk drive at all. And I've said it previously in the past that I've moved more away from disk and I'm pretty much an all digital download person for games. And it's just a much easier hassle for me when you've got kids, the hardware disk, they can get damaged, and it's something that I've kind of moved away from. So this is something that we're definitely expecting, especially after Sony's digital edition move with their PS5 and also originally with Xbox with the original Xbox One S all digital edition. Xbox are claiming up to 120 frames a second next-gen gaming, but this will definitely be game dependent. The performance of the Series X will definitely be lower than the Series X, which we'll get onto later on down the line. Now, in terms of the official performance and tech specs, Microsoft have not yet put out anything official out there and will be doing so, as I said, in the near future. But they are stated, and they have stated, that the Series S is aiming for 1440p quad high definition up to 120 frames a second next gen console gaming, DirectX ray tracing, and variable rate shading, VRS, variable refresh rate, 4K upscaling for games, and a custom 512 gigabyte storage for the NVMe internal, officially stated as well. But if we move over to some of what the rumors are saying and stating, it looks like we should be getting the same CPU performance with the 8-core Zen 2 7 nanometer AMD processors that's in there that matches up to the Series X. You should be getting less system RAM at 10 gigabytes of GDDR6 as well, and a rated compute power of 4 teraflops of the GPU compute performance, still based around the new Navi RDNA 2 graphics architecture from Radeon AMD. Now, how true it is still to be seen, and you need to take it with a grain of salt and confirm directly from Microsoft. But so far, with how things have been going, this is shaping up to be true enough for sure, especially at the price point that has been stated. Now, the confirmed date, again, directly from Microsoft, which is such a good look, is set for November 10th, and I'm pretty sure the Xbox Series X will be right alongside it on the same date, and we're probably going to be looking at a price of $499 or £449, which, if that's the case for the Series X, then personally I think that is a solid price point for next gen console gaming for both these consoles. Man, there is still a lot to play between Xbox and PlayStation, but man, when official news drops like this, it just keeps getting better and better. It looks like with this approach, and with Xbox Game Pass as well, Microsoft really wants to guarantee as many people have a chance of experiencing next-gen gaming consoles ASAP, from the jump, without any delays. There's probably going to be more follow-up content I'm going to have on this battle. There's still a lot to play out. The months till November are not gone yet. And this is exciting stuff, man. Let me know in the comment section below, what side are you on? Or are you gonna be team both and just get both as it is? What's your thoughts on the Series X? How's it shaping up? What are you excited for? Let me know in the comment section below. Let's have a discussion. Again, Ben from Lover of Tech. If you do enjoy content like this, you know exactly what to do. Hit that like button, hit that subscribe button, hit that notification bell so you're part of Team TLS, the Tech Lover Squad, so you don't miss any future videos that is posted on the Lover of Tech channel. I hope you guys are safe during this time. I will catch you in the next one. Peace.